involved in reaching the lost or in the Great Commission, would you say that would be by steps, like in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, or would you say simultaneously? How does that work?
Yeah, simultaneously, because obviously we cannot reach those that are across the way ourselves. We can't be in all places at one time, and so I believe the only way that we can be simultaneously involved and be right with the Scriptures and line with Scriptures is to send others.
Yeah.
Whether that be support missionaries that already exist or send them out of our church and raise up missionaries amongst our congregation.
Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor. Thank you, Brother Will. Your position regarding separation?
I believe that in order for a believer to practice consistent Christian living, it is necessary to be separated from habits, words, actions, aliases, and anything else that pertains to life, we believe, before salvation. I believe that the new birth produces a new manner of living. I believe that the Christian can have victory in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay,
Pastor? Yes, my question would be to you, Richard. What are some of the practices as a Christian and as a preacher you would not only separate yourself from, but lovingly yet firmly preach and teach your people to do the same?
That's big.
Just mention.
Well, I believe that separation is not isolation. I believe it's a heart issue, it's an attitude. But I do think that we physically do need to hold ourselves off from certain things. Alcohol would be one of them. I believe that evil communication corrupts with moral. I think it's an iron sharpens iron. You can be around people that are going to sharpen you, they're going to encourage you. They're going to. I think fellowship is a big part of that. I think that's why fellowship is so important when it comes to Christian growth. I think as a pastor, you should never be satisfied with where you're at. You should always seek to grow in your ministry, grow in your faith. No way it can happen is through practicing some parts of separation in your walk with the Lord. I think your closest friends should be those that are, you know, that encourage you in that way. People who are stable, people who are grounded, rooted. Also, when it comes to certain issues of modesty that are important, obviously, music is important. The places. I mean, to some extent, the places we go. So many of those things that would either ruin our testimonies or render us ineffective for the kingdom of God are all important when it comes to this. I think it's ultimately about glorifying God. People might believe.
Amen.
Let me just ask one more question.
Yes, absolutely.
As a pastor, would you perform a wedding ceremony for someone that had been previously divorced? Why and why not? Or why not? What's your position?
It depends on the circumstance. It depends on, if it meets the biblical criteria, I don't think I'm divorced. I don't think the Bible does, but I think there are certain criteria in the Scriptures. I will go according to the Scripture on that stance.
What would be your stance? Your position?
Well, the Bible makes it very clear there's been acts of adultery. You know, of course, if I was the pastor that had it in the church, I would try to prevent the divorce. But if that person came to my church and that had taken place, that's one of the ground rules that the Bible states. We have to be solely according to the Scripture.
Okay, thank you, Pastor. Okay, I would like to go ahead and direct your attention to Brother Williams' current education and experience. I know this regarding secular education. He has a Bachelor of Science in Biology and Geology Education, Master of Arts in Guidance and Counseling regarding ministerial. If you'll notice on page 4, through Shining Light College, which is a satellite of Tabernacle Baptist Bible College, Greenville, South Carolina. He took the equivalents of what would basically be an associate's degree, which included the Gospel of John, Romans, Acts, Old Testament Survey, Baptist History, Sunday School Administration, several years ago, as a matter of fact, called Operation Go, which is a college-level personal soul winning ministry teaching program. And so I would cheerfully add that to that area. And so, men, any questions? I think anyone who has, we'll take a couple of questions regarding this area. And anyone who would choose to come to?
Since they just took the equivalent of associate degree, did you complete their program?
Well, the program, when I started about halfway through the first year, they actually closed that program down. So that program got moved out. I mean, Roy was a part of that program. And it got shut down, basically.
But you were there until they...
Right.
I just like to see that because I like to see someone that finishes this.
Oh,
see,
yeah.
As you finish that.
Yeah, definitely.
But you did what they had until...
Okay. Any other questions along those lines? All right. Brother Will, would you please share your testimony?
Basically, I grew up in a traditional church that taught Bible stories as a child, and my grandfather was the one that was significant taking us to church, and I was even baptized, and I don't remember the age, but I was probably 10 or younger when I got baptized. Still remember wearing my pajamas. Got baptized in pajamas, but anyway, I remember I left home when I was about 14 years old. Didn't really go to church at all throughout my junior high, high school years, and when I started attending college, playing college ball, I felt the void in my life for the first time. Something was missing. And I remember telling God that I promised Him I was going to try to attend church, and I started going to church and going to different places, and still feeling good about going, but having that empty void in my life, and wound up, you know, a couple years later being injured, some other things happened. God used those things in my life. One day, a young man came to a Bible study. He actually invited me for a whole entire year to go to his Bible study. And finally, I had to say yes. He kept bugging me. And I remember very vividly him saying, you know, you got to remember to put God first in life. I know I wasn't doing that. That convicted me. And I remember attending this Bible study with about 25 college students. And there's a young man there who was teaching the Bible. It was the first time I heard somebody open the scriptures and teach from the Bible. God spoke to me that day, and I said, man, there's something about this. I want to know more. And I remember going to him and asking him what he wanted to church, and going to a little Baptist church there, and I started to attend, and same thing there. The pastor continued the onslaught of preaching, and God continued to convict me, and I began for the first time in my life to realize that I wasn't right with God, and I needed to make peace with Him. And after the course of a couple of weeks doing a revival, I went down front, and got on my knees and cried to God, and my life completely changed. You know, I saw things I'd never seen before, and I began to be more conscious of things around me, the sin around me, condition of man around me, all those kind of things. So,
questions?
Specific time where God called me. It wasn't like a day I could remember, or I wasn't at a crusade or something. God said, okay, I called you to preach, but I would just say it was a desire, the way I like to put it. Shortly after getting saved, I remember going into a college, a second college course, and I was sitting there just thinking about, I wonder how many people here are saved. And just having a burden for people, burden for the lost, and just going to church and hearing the pastor preach and being so in tune with the message, and then all of a sudden thinking about what I might preach, you know, just thinking about, I'm creating messages in my mind, and during this whole time, I'm thinking, you know what, I don't enjoy public speaking. That's the last thing I want to do is get up before people, and especially, you know, preach, you know. In that way, I didn't have a desire, but God kept tugging at my heart about, you know something other people don't know. I want you to tell people
they need to hear it. And then that went from that to me just doing it, being obedient, not really enjoying it initially, but doing it, and then God just really moved my heart and burdened me and just gave me the desire now to really want to do it. So now I love it. I wouldn't change the world. I can't think of anything else I'd rather do. So I would say my calling is just a desire. A desire to see other people grow in the Lord. I enjoy seeing people grow. I enjoy seeing people love God and realize what He's all about. So.
Amen. Any questions?
You pretty much answered my question, just to confirm. You said something. Is this the way I feel? Probably all these men up here too. Can you see yourself doing anything else?
No.
Absolutely. I mean, I understand you might work with secular jobs, but can you see yourself doing anything
absolutely
else?
Nothing gives me the joy. My life would be a use of something. I just don't have a reason to live.
Amen. Amen. All right. I'm going to ask Reverend Tom if he would come. And men, I'm going to thank you very much for the will. Thank you very, very much. This wasn't as painful as you might have thought it was going to be. You will pull your teeth out later on. But other than that, this completes the examination portion of this. I'm going to escort these pastors around the south side of the building. We're going to visit for just a little bit, and we will be back. I'm going to, Brother Will, you'd like to have a seat there on the, alongside your family. I asked Brother Tom to come on up here, and maybe, I don't know if I have a piano player, but if I don't, we can sure do it a cappella. You do a couple of songs, maybe some testimony, and we'll be back. We should be gone for very long.
Sit out here and observe and feel the same way. And right now, I just feel like, let's look to the Lord and just thank Him for what He's doing. Thank you for Brother Will and these men who come alongside to confirm the calling that Brother Will pulls on His heart. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so, so much for what you have done in this church by using Brother Will. Actually, Lord, we just thank you for his testimony. We thank you for his ministry here. We thank you for his desire to serve.